have come to bow down in worship, lifting up our hearts, we bow down in praise. Lover of my soul, hallelujah, hallelujah. With all of heaven, we are singing. Oh, we sing it out. Hallelujah. holy, you're holy. Alleluia, alleluia, alleluia. Holy are you to the left, all glory and power. Holy are you, Lord. Holy are you. Unto the Lamb who sits on the throne, all glory and power, all the praise is yours. And unto the Lamb who sits on the throne, all glory and power, all the praise is yours, it's yours. And unto the Lamb, he sits on the throne, all glory and power, all the praise is yours, it's yours, it's yours. Unto the Lamb, he sits on the throne, all glory and power, all the praise is yours, it's yours. Yeah, unto the Lamb, he sits on the throne, all glory and power, all the praise is yours, all the praise is yours. Yeah. All glory and power, come on. All the praise is yours forevermore. Not to the Lamb who sits on the throne, all glory and power.
Holy, Praise the again. In the morning that you rose, all of heaven held its breath till that stone was moved for good, for the Lamb that conquered death. And the dead rose from their tombs, and the angels stood in awe, for the souls of all who'd come to the Father are restored. And the church of Christ was born, and the Spirit lit the flame. Now this gospel truth of old shall not kneel, shall not fade. By His blood,
so exalt and lift. king of my heart. Be the mountain where I run, the fountain I drink from. Oh, he is my song. And let the king of my heart be the shadow of my right, the ransom for my life. Oh, he is my song. 'Cause you are good, you're good. Oh, 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 and let the king of my heart be the wind inside my sails, the anchor in the waves. Oh, he is my song. And let the king of my heart be the fire inside my veins, the echo in my days. Oh, he is my song. And let the king of my heart be the wind inside my sails, the anchor in the waves. Oh, he is my song. And let the king of my heart be the fire inside my veins, the echo of my days. Oh, he is my song. You are good, you're good. Oh, you are good, you're good. Oh, you are good, you're good.
You're never gonna let me down. been so good.
You're gonna let me down.
You'll never.
He's been faithful. Sing that.
Oh,
you're never gonna let.
Never gonna let.
Oh, you're
never gonna let. You're never gonna let me down.
Since when has he ever failed us?
You're never gonna let me down.
Through the highs, through the lows, you've been faithful.
sing out our own song to the Lord, a song of thankfulness, because he's so faithful and he's been so good. So let's sing out our own song of thankfulness.
For Honor and the praise, and to the one.
is like a boy. Who is like a Lord? 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 Yes.
You're so beautiful. rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground, he took the fall and thought of me above all, above all powers, above all kings, above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man. You were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known, above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you're worth. Crucified, laid behind a stone, you lived to die, rejected. Above all nature and all created things, above all wisdom and all the ways of man. You were here before the world began. Above all kingdoms, above all thrones, above all wonders the world has ever known, above all wealth and treasures of the earth, there's no way to measure what you rejected and alone, like a rose trampled on the ground, you took the fall and thought of me above
rejected.
protected and loved like a rose trampled on the ground. He took the fall and thought of me above all. You are the love of my life. You are the hope that I cling to. You
Holy Spirit, we know you're in the room, and we thank you, Lord, for your nearness. Thank you that we get to be in your presence, Lord. Thank you that we get to be in your house and worship you and look to you, God. We magnify you, Jesus. We love you so much, and we give you the glory. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, you guys, we're going to step into a time of taking communion. I just want to invite you all in the room and those watching online to go ahead and grab your elements as we partake as a school. Just want to encourage you guys to be expectant that anything could happen right now in his presence. The healers in the room, the redeemers in the room. I'll be reading out of 1 Corinthians 15. This is Paul saying, "Moreover, brethren, I declare to you the gospel which I preached to you, which also you received and in which you stand, by which also you are saved, if you hold fast that word which I preached to you, unless you believed in vain. For I delivered to you first of all that which I also received, that Christ died for our sins according to the scriptures, and that he was buried, and that he rose again the third day according to the scriptures. Verse 20, but now Christ is risen from the dead and has become the first fruits of those who have fallen asleep. For since by man came death, by man also came the resurrection of the dead. For as in Adam all die, even so in Christ all shall be made alive." And Lord, we just thank you that you prepare a table for us to come and feast with you at, that we get to partake of your body, Lord, and to remember all that you've done for us, Jesus. We remember that you came to this earth, Lord, that you became a man and that you humbled yourself to the point of death, even death on a cross, Jesus. Thank you that you endured the cross, you endured the agony, that you were rejected, that you were despised, that you were spit upon, mocked for us, Lord. And thank you, Lord, that you're now seated at the right hand of the Father, interceding on our behalf, Lord. Thank you that wholeness and healing and life and joy and peace is available right now. So, Lord, we lift this bread in remembrance of you, and we break it in remembrance of your body that was broken, Lord, and we received everything that you paid for. We claim it as ours, Lord. And we are just so grateful for you, Lord. We won't forget what you've done. We love you, Lord. We adore you. We bless you, and we receive you right now. In Jesus' name.
Thank you, Jesus. I'm just going to read from Colossians 1. The word says, "For it was the Father's good pleasure for all the fullness to dwell in Christ, and through him to reconcile all things to himself, having made peace through the blood of his cross." Oh, Jesus, thank you. It was the Father's great pleasure to give up his only son so that we may have life. There's no greater act, no greater display of love than the cross of Jesus Christ, that you willingly watched your son pour out every ounce of his blood so that we can have relationship with you again. So Lord, we lift your blood high, knowing that your blood is perfect, it is spotless, that there is power in the blood of Jesus, that all sickness has to go with the blood of Jesus. I thank you that there is freedom in your blood, Lord. freedom for every wayward thought, God. That we find everything we need in your blood. Thank you for the honor, for the privilege of getting to partake of your covenant meal, Lord. We thank you that you paid for it all on the cross, and you paid for this moment right now. For your blood to pay for every sickness in this room, for every healing that's about to take place. We thank you, Lord, that it is paid for already by your blood. And so we receive it now, Lord, in faith, knowing that it is finished by the work of your cross. In Jesus' name, receive.
Lord, we just thank you just for your healing power and the power of your blood, God. And we just thank you just for touching bodies right now in this room, touching bodies on the live stream, just bringing health, healing, and wholeness because of your sacrifice and the great price that you paid, Jesus. Lord, we love you, we worship you, and we thank you so much, Jesus, for all that you do. Amen. Amen. All right, guys. So I have the honor this morning of receiving the tithes and offerings. And I wanted to read a scripture out of the book of Proverbs, Proverbs 11:24. And it says, "There is one who scatters, yet increases more. And there is one who withholds more than is right, but it leads to poverty. The generous soul will be made rich, and he who waters will also be watered himself." And we serve such a generous God, such a giving God. And you know, the Bible says, I don't know if it's just a saying people say, I'll have to look it up later, but they say it's more blessed than to receive. And so why would it be more blessed to receive or to give than to receive? And it's because when you give, two people are getting blessed in the situation. The person you're giving to is being blessed, and you're being blessed as well. And that's why it's greater to give than to receive. You know, the Lord isn't looking for someone who's super, super smart in business and advertising and raising money. He's just looking for somebody that'll live before him like this, with an open hand. You know, it says here that he who waters will be watered himself. And so if you live before God, I have it even written here in my Bible, as long as you give away what the Lord puts in your hand, there will always be something in your hand to give away. And it's as we live before him like this that he can pour forth through us. And it's impossible for a river to flow through you and you not get wet. But if you live before the Lord like this, it says right here that it leads to poverty. And so not only will he not be able to bless through you, but you will also dry up yourself and there will be a drought. And so we want to be people that live before him like this, a generous God. There's levels of his generosity you won't learn and understand and see until you become a generous person yourself. And so we want to be like the Lord. We want to be a generous people, and we also want to be a blessing and a conduit so he can pour forth through our lives. And so I'm going to pray over today's offering. And so, Lord, we just thank you so much that you're a generous God, that you're a giving God, that you've given all to us, Lord. It says all good things have come from you, Lord. And so, Lord, I just pray that you make us a generous people, that we would be generous with tithes and offerings, that we'd be generous with everything that you give us, God. And, Lord, I pray that this offering be blessed and multiplied, and then yet be multiplied back to those who give. And Lord, we just thank you, Lord, so much for everything that you give and provide for us each and every single day. In Jesus' name, amen. All right, so if you're watching online, you can text the number that's on your screen. If you're in the room, you can give to the buckets or text the number that's on the screen here as well.